The two triangles below are similar. Determine the ratio of the corresponding sides, the ratio of the perimeters, and the ratio of the areas. Determine the ratios comparing the small triangle to the large triangle. Looking at the two similar triangles, notice how this side corresponds to this side. This side corresponds to this side. And finally, this side corresponds to this side. Let's look at the ratios of the corresponding sides. Again, comparing the small triangle to the large triangle, we have the ratio of 4 centimeters to 6 centimeters. The ratio of 6 centimeters to 9 centimeters. And the ratio of 8 centimeters to 12 centimeters. Notice in each ratio, the units of centimeters will simplify out because centimeters divided by centimeters is equal to 1. And now let's simplify each ratio. We simplify ratios just like we simplify fractions. For the first ratio of 4 to 6, the greatest common factor between 4 and 6 is 2. To simplify, we divide 4 by 2 and 6 by 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 6 divided by 2 is 3, giving us the ratio of 2 to 3. The greatest common factor between 6 and 9 is 3. To simplify, we divide 6 by 3 and 9 by 3. 6 divided by 3 is 2. 9 divided by 3 is 3, again giving us the ratio of 2 to 3. The greatest common factor between 8 and 12 is 4. To simplify, we divide both values by 4. 8 divided by 4 is 2. 12 divided by 4 is 3, once again giving us the ratio of 2 to 3. The ratio of the corresponding sides is 2 to 3. And now let's find the ratio of the perimeters. To find the perimeter, we sum the lengths of the sides. So the perimeter of the small triangle, which we'll label P sub S, is equal to 4 centimeters plus 6 centimeters plus 8 centimeters. 4 plus 6 plus 8 is 18. The perimeter of the small triangle is 18 centimeters. And now we'll find the perimeter of the large triangle, which is equal to 6 centimeters plus 9 centimeters plus 12 centimeters. 6 plus 9 plus 12 is equal to 27. The perimeter of the large triangle is 27 centimeters, which means the ratio of the perimeters is 18 centimeters to 27 centimeters. Again, the units of centimeters simplify out. The greatest common factor between 18 and 27 is 9. To simplify the ratio, we divide 18 by 9 and 27 by 9. 18 divided by 9 is 2. 27 divided by 9 is 3. The ratio of the perimeters is the same as the ratio of the corresponding sides, which is 2 to 3. Now we will determine the ratio of the areas. The area of a triangle is equal to 1 half base times height. So the area of the small triangle is equal to 1 half times the base of 8 centimeters times the height of 3 centimeters. 1 half times 8 times 3 will give us the area of the small triangle. 1 half times 8 is 4, 4 times 3 is 12. The area of the small triangle is 12 square centimeters. And now we'll find the area of the large triangle, which is 1 half times the base of 12 centimeters times the height of 4.5 centimeters. Multiplying 1 half times 12 is 6. The area is equal to 6 times 4.5. Let's write 6 as a fraction with a denominator of 1. We'll write 4.5 as an improper fraction. The denominator remains 2. The numerator is 2 times 4 plus 1, which is 9. 4.5 is equal to 9 halves. And now we simplify before multiplying. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 3 2s and 6. We now have 3 times 9, which is 27, giving us an area of 27 square centimeters. which means the ratio of the areas is 12 centimeters squared to 27 centimeters squared. The units of square centimeters simplifies out. The greatest common factor between 12 and 27 is 3. To simplify the ratio, we divide 12 by 3 and we divide 27 by 3. 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4, and 27 divided by 3 is 9. The ratio of the areas is not the same as the ratio of the sides and the ratio of the perimeters. The ratio of the areas is 4 to 9. Notice how if we begin with the ratio of the sides or the ratio of the perimeters, which is 2 to 3, and then we square the 2 and we square the 3, this does give us the ratio of the areas, which is 4 to 9. So it is true, the ratio of the areas is always the square of the ratio of the sides or the ratio of the perimeters. And this is not only true for similar triangles, it's true for all similar polygons. Let's summarize this. If the ratio of the sides of two similar polygons is A to B, then the ratio of the perimeters is also A to B. And here's an example. If the ratio of the sides of two similar polygons is A to B, then the ratio of the areas is A squared to B squared. And again, here's an example. I hope you found this helpful.